Welcome back. As people continue to lose jobs in California, it's translating into more people who can't afford to pay their mortgages.
As it stands right now, a record number of mortgages are delinquent. 13% of American homeowners behind on their mortgage payments, and it is no longer just those high-risk subprime loans. KCRA3's Tom Duhane with a look at the new wrinkle in the foreclosure mess.
This is the busy office of WorkNet in Stockton, where people get help finding jobs. With unemployment at 15.5% in San Joaquin County, job losses have now spread to positions previously stable, like government and
all of the school districts. We've seen job losses in the city of Stockton. We've seen job losses in the county. So you're talking about jobs that generally pay a very good wage with good benefits.
For most families, it takes two incomes to support a home mortgage.
You know, playing out.
UOP economist Jeff Michael says losing one of those incomes can be disastrous.
So, you know, your ability to refinance the home or to work something out with your lender is diminished. Your ability to sell the home and move on is diminished, and all that drives up foreclosure rates.
Unfortunately, the short-term outlook for jobs isn't good, so the foreclosures will continue. What's new in Stockton is the mortgage failure rates going up for the fixed mortgages, those 15-year, 30-year reliable fixed mortgages. No, not those variable subprime mortgages, the stable mortgages. And experts say the reason this is happening now is because of increasing unemployment.
I think foreclosure rates are going to stay above historic norms for 3-4 years still.
In Stockton, Tom Duhane, KCRA3 reports.
Joining us live tonight to talk about the options that are out there for homeowners who are struggling to pay the bills is Cherie Tiscarino with the group Hope Against Hope. It's an organization that helps people who are facing foreclosure. So, Cherie, let's start out with whether you're seeing what we're hearing from these surveys, that these are now responsible people used to paying the bills with those regular fixed-rate mortgages.
Absolutely, Edie and Galston. These statistics reveal the truth, and that is the folks that are being affected most today by the foreclosure crisis are people who have a history of paying their bills on time and being hardworking, responsible citizens.
So at this point, now, it seems like what I'm hearing is if you feel like you're getting in trouble and you see foreclosure coming, I mean, now's the time to really check that pride at the door, right?
Absolutely. All of the stigmas attached to foreclosure are antiquated and no longer are helping us. So the sooner we can all let go of that and realize that everybody's being affected today, the sooner we can focus our attention where it really belongs, which is getting a solution.
So what can people do? I mean, what is part of that solution?
The three most important things. Number one, get real with your finances. Know what you can afford and know what you can't afford. Number two, educate yourself so that you know how to properly go to your lender and ask for the help so that you have the best chances to get it. And then number three, have a backup plan. Statistics show that not everybody asking for help for it to be affordable to stay in their home is getting it. And so know what to do if you can't get that help so that you can avoid the permanence of having a foreclosure on your record.
We have heard so many nightmare stories about those loan modification companies and people putting a lot of money into that and getting nothing in return, not even their money back. What can you tell people about trying to get the help that they need?
You can do this on your own. I just read a recent statistic that said that only 20% of the people who've actually paid a loan modification company has actually received one. Those are very dismal statistics, and the truth is with the right education, a homeowner can do it on their own and get the same exact, actually better results in most cases.
So these days, I mean, with this new phenomenon we're seeing, with these new wave of foreclosures, because people just simply don't have a job, don't have an income, is there a way you can talk to your bank about, hey, look, I lost my job, I need some more time? I mean, what kind of leeway is there In that area?
Generally speaking, if you do not have a job and you're on unemployment, you will be able to get some extensions, generally speaking, and get more time. But eventually, if you can't seek employment, you're probably not going to be able to get a loan modification is the truth that can allow you to stay in your home, and you're going to have to look at other foreclosure prevention options, such as possibly a short sale.
So, Cherie, give us an indication of, from the people you work with, how successful are folks in at least protecting their credit in all of this?
Well, in most cases, the truth is, I would say that 75% of the people who find themselves in the all-too-common situation where they can't afford their payments end up having their credit damaged to some degree through the process. I would say only a small percentage can get through it and get the modification they need while staying current and protecting their credit. That's the truth.
All right. Well, we need more truth out there these days when it comes to this kind of thing. Sheree Tiscarino with Hope Against Hope. Good luck in your endeavors, and thanks for talking with us today.
Thank you.
All right. Well, there are three foreclosure prevention workshops scheduled in the next few weeks.
The first one is next Thursday. That's August 27th at the Arcade Public Library in Sacramento. Then on September 10th, the workshop will be held in Rockland at the Rockland Placer Library. September 22nd, you can get help in Elk Grove at the Elk Grove Public Library. And by the way, you need to sign up for these workshops in advance, because there is a lot of interest out there. Go to kcra.com and click on the As Seen On section for a link to the Hope Against Hope site.